So electrostatics, next chapter. Already this chapter we have studied in 11th standard also. Again here we are going to study electrostatics. In 11th standard you have studied electric field intensity, electric potential. So all these basic concepts we have to use in this chapter, and we have to study Gauss law. Fine. So we know that, okay, Gauss law gives the relationship between electric charge and electric field. So it also provides the equivalent methods for finding the electric field intensity by relating values of the field at a closed surface and total charges enclosed by that surface. So it is a powerful tool which can be applied for the calculation of the electric field when it originates from the charge distribution of sufficient symmetry. So the law can be written as phi, okay. So this phi is equal to q upon epsilon 0, which is equal to closed integral of E dot ds, vector E dot vector ds, where phi is the total flux coming out of a closed surface and q is the total charge inside the closed surface. So common steps involved in calculating electric field intensity by using Gauss law theorem. So what is that? Describe the charge distribution, linear surface and volume. Then obtain the flux by Gauss theorem, let this by equation A also. Visualize Gaussian surface and justify it. So next, with the electric field intensity E as unknown, obtain electric flux by calculation. So using geometry of the structure, symmetry of Gaussian surface, let us this equation will be B. Now equating RHS of equation A and B, and we can calculate electric field intensity, that is E. So we will see its application. So in this section we will see how to obtain the electric field intensity for symmetric charge configuration with the help of the some examples. So first of all we will see about its spherical shell. Okay, electric field intensity due to uniformly charged spherical shell or hollow sphere. Consider a sphere of radius capital R with its center at O, charged to a uniform charge density sigma, that is coulomb per meter square, placed in a dielectric medium of permittivity epsilon. So epsilon equal to epsilon 0 k, the total charge on sphere is equal to, so sigma is equal to charge per unit area, so charge is equal to sigma into area, that is 4 pi r square. So by Gauss theorem, the net flux through a closed surface, that is phi, is equal to q upon epsilon 0. So for air vacuum, k is equal to 1, where q is the total charge inside the closed surface. Then this is the uniformly charged spherical shell or hollow sphere. So to find electric intensity at point P, which is situated at distance r from center of the charged sphere, imagine a concentric Gaussian sphere of radius r passing through a point P. So wherever we have shown one small circle, okay, which is elliptical along the curve. So Gaussian sphere of radius r passing through a point P. Let ds be small area of the point P on the Gaussian surface. So due to symmetry and spheres being concentric, the electric field at each point on Gaussian surface has same magnitude, that is E, and it is directed radially outward. Also, the angle between the direction of E and the normal to the surface of sphere, that is ds, is 0, so cos theta is equal to 1. Because E dot ds is equal to E ds cos theta, and cos 0 is 1 because E and ds both are in same direction. So therefore flux d phi through the area ds is equal to E ds, So total electric flux through the Gaussian surface phi is equal to closed integral of E dot ds, which is E ds again. E closed integral of ds that we have calculated outside the integration, because ds is varying term, okay, and E is constant. And we know that if you calculate integration of ds, okay, that will be 4 pi r square. So phi is equal to E into 4 pi r square. So from equation 8.1 and 8.2, so this is equation 8.2, and whatever this equation, this 8.1, okay, we can see this term here also, okay, that is Q upon epsilon 0 is equal to E 4 pi r square, where E is equal to Q upon 4 pi epsilon 0 into r square, since Q is equal to sigma into 4 pi r square. So we have E is equal to sigma into 4 pi r square upon 4 pi epsilon 0 small r square. So where 4 pi will cancel out. Therefore, E is equal to sigma r square upon epsilon 0 small r square. So from equation 8.3, it can be seen that the electric field at a point outside the shell is the same as that due to point charge. Thus, it can be concluded that uniformly charged sphere is equivalent to a point charge at its center. So we can see on the basis of it two cases. Case one is if point P lies on the surface of the charged sphere, okay. So same here, whatever this given in diagram, okay, on charged sphere, okay, outside the surface, then small r is equal to capital R, okay. So if E is equal to Q upon 4 pi epsilon 0 into capital R square, which is equal to sigma upon epsilon 0. Then case 2, if point P lies inside the charge sphere, since there are no charges inside, so because sigma equal to 0, then E is equal to also 0. In this way, you can show this electric field around the sphere. Now, electric field intensity due to infinitely long straight charge wire. Okay, so if you want to see, you can see this diagram also. Okay, infinitely long straight charge wire. Consider a uniformly charged wire of infinite length having a constant linear charge density lambda, charge per unit length, kept in a medium of permittivity epsilon, that is equal to epsilon 0 k. So infinitely long straight charge wire, okay, that is called also a cylinder. So to find electric intensity at point P at distance r from charge wire, imagine a coaxial Gaussian cylinder of length L and radius r, so closed at each end by plane caps normal to the closed axis. So radius r passing through the point P, okay. So inside that cylinder, consider a very small area ds at point P on the Gaussian surface. So whatever dotted line we have shown, that is your Gaussian surface. So by symmetry, the magnitude of the electric field will be same at all points on the curved surface of the cylinder and will be directed radially outward. So the angle between the direction of E and normal to the surface of cylinder ds is 0, because again theta will be 0, okay. So E dot ds is equal to E ds cos theta, okay, so it will be cos 0, again cos 0 will be 1, that is E ds. So flux d phi through the area ds is equal to E ds. So total electric flux through the Gaussian surface will be what? Phi is equal to closed integral of E dot ds. Again, E will be calculated closed integral of ds, so phi is equal to E into 2 pi RL. So from equation 8.1 and 8.5, Q upon epsilon 0 is equal to E into 2 pi RL. Since lambda is equal to Q upon L, or Q is equal to lambda into L. So lambda L upon epsilon 0 is equal to E 2 pi RL, where LL will cancel out here, and lambda is equal to 2 E is equal to lambda upon 2 pi epsilon 0 into R. Okay, so this is the expression for electric intensity due to an infinitely long straight charge wire. So direction of electric field E, and E is directed outward if lambda is positive, okay, inward if lambda is negative. It depends upon the value of lambda, okay, that we have considered here a charge, okay, or shortly linear charge density. Then we will see about electric field due to a charge infinite plane shape. Okay, so see here next application. Infinite plane sheet. Consider a uniform charge infinite plane sheet with surface charge density sigma. By symmetry, electric field is perpendicular to the plane sheet and directed outward, having same magnitude at a given distance on either side of the sheet. So let P be a point at a distance r from sheet, okay, and E be the electric field at point P. So to find electric field due to a charge infinite plane sheet at P, we consider a Gaussian surface around P in the form of a cylinder having cross sectional area A, capital A, and its length is 2r. Why 2r? Because r and r, okay, on both sides it will be r plus r, 2r, with its axis perpendicular to the plane sheet. The plane sheet passes through the middle of the length of the cylinder such that ends of cylinder called end caps, that is P and P dash, okay, are equidistant at a distance r from the plane sheet. So in this way we can draw a Gaussian surface. Now by symmetry, the electric field is at right angles to the end caps and away from the plane. So its magnitude is same at P and P dash. The flux passing through the curved surface is zero, as the electric field is tangential to the surface. Therefore, the total flux through the closed surface is given by phi is equal to close integral of E dot ds P plus phi, that is close integral of E dot ds P dash. So in this way we can consider for P and P dash. Since theta equal to 0, again cos 0, 1, again it will be ds is equal to A. So EA plus EA, it will be 2EA, which is phi. So sigma is surface charge density. Then sigma is charge per unit area. So Q is equal to sigma into A. So equation 8.1 can be written as phi is equal to sigma A upon epsilon 0. So from equation 8.7 and 8.8, 2EA is equal to sigma A upon epsilon 0, where A will cancel out, so E is equal to sigma upon 2 epsilon 0, which is the required equation. Now we will see about its next point, that is electric potential and electric potential energy. Electric potential, okay, first we will see about that. We have studied earlier that potential energy of system is the stored energy that depends upon the relative positions of its constituents. So in electrostatics, potential energy is the work done against the electrostatic force to achieve a certain configuration of charges in a given system. Since every system tries to attain the lowest potential energy, work is always required to be done to change the configuration. So we know that work done is stored in the form of potential energy, because unit of work done is joule and unit of potential energy is also joule. So we will see that. We know that like charges repel and unlike charges attract each other. A charge exerts a force on any other charge in its vicinity. Some work is always done to move a charge in presence of another charge. So potential energy arises from any collection of charges. Consider a positive charge Q peaks at some point in space. For bringing any other positive charge close to it, work is necessary, and this work is equal to the change in potential energy of the system. So the work done against electrostatic force is equal to the increasing the potential energy of the system. So F dot dr is equal to du. Okay, so du is the increasing potential energy, where charge is displaced through dr and F is the force exerted on the charge. In this way, du is equal to F dot dr. Then expression for potential energy. Let us consider electrostatic field due to a source charge, that is plus Q, placed at origin O. Let a small charge plus Q zero be brought from point A to point B at respective distances R1 and R2 from point O against the repulsive force x on it. So Q zero will be placed at distance R1. Okay. Now, work done against the electrostatic force Fe is in displacing the charge Q0 through smallest displacement dr. Okay, small displacement, that is dr, appears as an increasing potential energy of system. So du is equal to F dot dr. Okay, so Fe dot dr, which is in minus sign because force and displacement are in opposite direction. Then negative sign appears because the displacement dr is against the electrostatic force. For displacement of the charge from initial position A to the final position B, the change in potential energy delta U can be obtained by integrating. So that is delta U is equal to integration. Okay, integration of what term? Okay, you can see here R1 to R2 du, which is equal to the integration R1 to R2 minus Fe dot dr, which is electrostatic force, that is Coulomb force, between the two charges separated by a distance r8. Okay, so we will see that Fe is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 q 0 upon r square into r cap, where r cap is a unit vector in the direction of vector r bar. So negative sign shows vector r bar and Fe are in oppositely directed. So for system 2-point charges, okay, we have calculated integration of r1 to r2 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 q0 upon r square r cap dot r, okay, where 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 q0 is we have calculated outside of this integration because it is constant, and just taken integration of 1 upon r square is what, 1 upon r, and put its limit r1 to r2, you will get 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 q0 1 upon r2 minus 1 upon r1. So the change in potential energy depends only upon the end points and is independent of actual path taken by the charge. The change in the potential energy is equal to the work done AB against the electrostatic force, that is delta U is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 q0 into 1 upon r2 minus 1 upon r1. So far, we have defined and calculated the change in potential energy of system of charges. It is convenient to choose infinity to be the point of zero potential energy, as electrostatic force is at zero at r equal to infinity. So potential energy U of the system of 2-point charges Q1 and Q2 separated by distance r can be obtained from the above equation by using R1 is equal to infinity and R2 is equal to R. So it will be U of R, that is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 upon R. Okay, and that is your required equation, that is for potential energy. Okay, again we have some concepts of potential, okay, that we will see about in next lecture.